Your Excellency, Nyesom is the one we
APC has saved Nigerians. Why you see many people debating the APC? It will be shame. But those who have heart, who believe in this country, watch what will happen. Nobody's interested in APC. What are you going to tell us again? What will APC tell Nigerians? They will do this, excuses. They will do that, excuses. Somebody will not put to bed, it is a PDP. Somebody has not eaten, it is a what? PDP. You knew these problems were there. And you came and told Nigerians, as we come, we are going to change all these things. And things will be better. Are things better today?
No.
Are things better today?
No.
So why do you like people to tell you lies and lies and lies and lies? How long can you continue to listen to the lies of the All Progressive Congress? They are coming from Nigerians. It's unfortunate. There was a conspiracy to remove another data personal president. Today, everybody's seen it. Some people came here to say that there's no East West Road, it's not done. That how can our son be there and they did not do East West Road? That if they vote for APC, East West Road will be done. Has it been done?
No.
Has it been done?
No.
Now they are coming to tell you they're going to give you a university of transport. Time is ending. They'll give you a DC Ford and they'll give you a park, industrial park. Come on, we must tell people that, my friend, I'm too good for these stories now. I'm too good for these stories. Enough is there. By next year, political activities will kickstart. When will they do the infrastructure again? Somebody will come and tell you people, federal government has approved pleasure, I mean, what do you call it, industrial park, they have approved deep sea in Boni, they've done this, they've done that. Look at since they started Boni with the road. What has happened? As we speak, federal government has not released their own counterpart funding for that road. It is LNG. Now LNG say, okay, let us do it. And then they talk from the past. That when they put the flag on them. Is it that they have been doing in other states?
No.
So my brothers and sisters, I welcome you back. Except a wicked man who does not like good things will see what is happening in Port Harcourt. The kind of thing we are doing to change Port Harcourt and bring it back what it used to be. We continue to be in APC. You know, there are people who are born to be wicked naturally. There are people who have born that they will never like good things, and may they never like good things in their life.
Amen.
Because good things will never come to them.
Amen.
Any person who loves River State, any person who believes in this state, cannot see what is going on in this state and say he will still remain in APC. That person does not love River State. So I thank you for this bold step you have taken. Do not be ashamed. There's nothing wrong that you have a problem with your father and then you go back and settle with your father. We're all human. Husband and wife will quarrel. At the end of the day, they settle. Where they cannot settle, they go for divorce. If it's a marriage instead of divorce, they go for separation. So that's how life is. So don't let nobody tell you that, oh, yes, you quarrel with your father. You are probably the way your father was, you are not happy. And now he said, Papa, enough is enough. Let's keep our family together. And that's what you have done. And I show you a good child. So I thank all of you, continue to give PDP the support you are giving. By our achievements, we have killed any party that wants to raise their head. It's by our achievements, by your support. On 29th of May, 2015, 27th of May, 2015, somebody said, let us see where we get money to pay salary, not to talk about doing a project. Today we're not talking about paying our salaries. We're going to employ 5,000 youths into the civil service. We're not talking about projects, we're talking about legacy projects. So, what is there? Let anybody come and challenge us. If you say we have not done well, come and tell us what we have not done well. I will tell you where you are living, how we are doing the road to your own house. Yes. Even when you are governor for 8 years, you wouldn't do it. Yeah. So, don't pity people should be ashamed. If you raise your hand high and say, look, this is the party I belong to. This is the party that has made us proud. This is the party that has told us that, look, nobody ventures to talk, to do anything against the interests of River State. I'm a full reverse man, and I continue to be a reverse man.
Yes.
I will defend the interest of River State. It doesn't matter whether you take one's life or not. Because it's important in life, that life, death will come when it will come. Nobody knows the day it will be. So you cannot be say, you can't say, I'm afraid of dying. You never can tell whether you're going to the house, you will die. People are sleeping, they can't wake up. Did they know they will die that day?
No.
So why are you going to be afraid of death? Because you want to defend the interests of your people. Continue to protect and defend the interests of your people. You will not die because God did not say you will die. But if God says you will die, there's nothing you can do. Thank you, and God bless you.